wife of a retiree and a member of Laws. I have been working with retirees and the families in Michigan and other states and in Washington, D.C. For 14 years now. White-collar workers have lost their health care and their pensions. Those who are 62 will fall under the federal guarantee, pension guarantee, and will receive reduced pensions, which is paid by the taxpayers. The blue-collar workers have lost their eye care and their dental. In 2006, GM asked the UAW to take over the health care in the form of BIVA, which was never voted on by the retirees or the union members. GM was supposed to put money into the BIVA, which it has not done in 2008 and 2009. BIVA takes over health care in 2010. Where is the money for this BIVA health care that starts in less than 4 months? It appears GM got rid of the health care, laid it on the backs of the workers, put the health care in the hands of a union that allowed GM to pay nothing for 2 years. The president's health care plan does not allow companies to abandon their health care plans. We need the community's help to stop the fraud and deceit of GM. Remember, GM and all its subsidiaries affect many communities and the many walks of life in your community. Communities need to stand up for the constituents and demand that the federal government help stop the fraud and deceit that is being perpetrated on the American citizens before they reach a point of no return.
My name is Stacy Curtis. I'm from Elkhart, Indiana. I've drove 6 hours to talk to the council this evening. My concerns are about the lack of misrepresentation from the UAW. The UAW had been in that facility since 1964. We got deserted in July of this year with no avail. We had no help from the UAW before the strike ever started. When we went out on strike, we went out on strike on April 1st of 2006. We went out with 230 people. The average age was 52. And the lowest seniority person on the list was 20 years. Most had between 30 to 45 years seniority. We have asked over and over for the director to help us out. We were on strike for 3 years. He came to our strike line one time in 2006 with a strategy of recessing the strike, which we voted down overwhelmingly. The company wanted to pick and choose who could come back into the facility. We all stood together and stood strong for 3 years on a strike line. Now, as of today, we were deserted in July of 2009. We were told on that day that we are no longer UAW members. We were told that they would give us insurance and benefits for 1 month. And back in 2006, when the director came into town, he told us that we would get up to 3 to 4 months of insurance. Now we have 122 families sitting in Elkhart, Indiana, with no insurance and no income and no jobs. Just like Michigan, there is no jobs in Elkhart. I'm asking the council to please help us to send letters. I've sent letters. I've sent many letters to Solidarity House. I'm here because I've asked them to come to our town. They would not come to our town, so I thought I'd come to the good old boys' town myself. And I thank you for listening.
I've worked for General Motors for 18 years and American Axle 10 years, retiring with a combination of 28 years. I was told, along with other salary employees, we would receive a retirement pension from both GM and American Axle. Axle became a company in March of 1994, when it bought 5 GM plants. When I retired in October of 2003, I received my first check from Axle and from Delphi, a company I never worked for. Delphi didn't exist until 1999. My Social Security work statement shows I'd only worked for General Motors and American Axle for 28 years. The question no one can answer is who has been paying Fidelity the monies to pay me a pension from Delphi. Now my pension is going to be paid by the PBGC at a reduced monthly cut, and the taxpayers are going to be the ones paying for it. The loss group knows GM has used $60 billion to become a new GM. It is time all communities such as this one to write and fax our government offices, such as our congressmen and senators, and ask them to support an investigation. I thank you for your time.
About abatements, tax abatements, which were granted to General Motors for plants in our area. In exchange, they were to build trucks and cars and give us jobs. Okay, we bought lots of cars and trucks from General Motors over the years. What happened to General Motors' loyalty to us? They sent jobs overseas and outsourced the jobs that we had been counting on. In 1987, as a social worker, I started to see the mental health crisis that was followed with massive job losses in our area. Alcohol, drug abuse, depression, and other mental illnesses, and suicide rates all skyrocketed and have not really gone down in all the time that I've been working in the social work field. Our cities in southeast Michigan and northern Indiana look like war zones due to the massive loss of tax revenue due to the loss of jobs. Many of our children and grandchildren have had to leave southeast Michigan in order to find employment, including some of the relatives here in Warren. This results in a massive loss of tax revenue for Warren, Michigan, and the rest of the state of Michigan. From the sounds of some of the things you're dealing with here tonight, it sounds to me like you're going to be needing a lot of tax revenue just to deal with some of the infrastructure that's going on in Warren, Michigan. So you're going to need some of this tax revenue, so even if this doesn't seem like it applies to you, it does apply to you. I ask that you, the members of the City Council of Warren,